In the Buddha's time, there was a monk named Tewatara who caused much strife amongst the ordained. He led his own group of evil monks, and he desperately sought the love and admiration that the Buddha received. He committed many evil actions in hopes of achieving this goal. One of the most heinous instances was his attempt to murder the Lord Buddha. While Tewatara was unsuccessful, he did injure the Buddha's foot. Dr. Chiwaka, the Buddha's personal physician, treated the injured foot and helped heal the wound. The monks who were gathered discussed the great evil Tewatara committed. When the Buddha heard what they had said, he told them, "Monks, this is not the first time Tewatara did evil and kept evil company." He then told them a story from the past. A long time ago, there was a king named Banjara who reigned in a city called Uttara Banjara. During that time, the Bodhisat was born as the son to the king of the parrots. He also had a brother. One day, the two parrot brothers were flying when there suddenly was a whirlwind. Vicious and strong winds blew each parrot in a different direction. As one brother fell from the sky, he was caught by the king of robbers. The king of robbers named this parrot Sattigumba, which meant bristling spears. Sattigumba spent all his time listening to the robbers talk about murder, robbery, and violence. The robbers chanted,
"Kill, rob, take everything, have no mercy."
Sattigumba adopted the thoughts of the bandits and began to join in the chanting.
"Kill, rob, take everything, no mercy."
The other brother fell onto the flowers near the hermitage of a sage. He was given the name Bupaka, the flower bird. Bupaka watched as the hermit taught his students. He taught them compassion, gratitude, kindness, humility, and restraint. Bupaka absorbed the teachings and said, "Compassion, gratitude, kindness, humility, and restraint." One day, King Banjara led a group out on a hunt. They found a grand deer, and King Banjara and his closest advisor gave chase. They charged deep into the forest and eventually lost sight of the deer. The advisor saw a nice clearing and invited King Banjara to take a rest. King Banjara rested against a tree and began to hear some voices. The king suddenly heard a sound. "Kill, rob, take everything, have no mercy. Kill, rob, take everything, have no mercy." King Banjara and his advisor jumped up and prepared for an attack. However, when they searched for the source of the sound, they found that it was merely a parrot who was saying those threatening words. The advisor prepared to kill the evil-speaking parrot, but the king had mercy. The king and his advisor traveled onward and arrived at a clearing in the forest. Once again, they heard a voice speaking. On high alert, they prepared for an attack. Compassion, gratitude, kindness, humility, and restraint. Compassion, gratitude, kindness, humility, and restraint. King Panjara and his advisor followed the voice and came upon the hermitage. King Panjara found the source of the voice to be the parrot Bupaka. Bupaka humbly bowed to the king and greeted him properly and courteously. King Panjara was impressed that a parrot could not only speak the words of men, but do so with the courtesy and humility. The king asked, "Bupaka, how is it that you are so courteous and refined when we just encountered another parrot, similar to you, that was vicious and evil?" "Great king of men, that was my brother Sattigumba. He and I were separated by a great wind. He must have fallen in with vicious bandits, as I have fallen in with the hermit. He has learned the ways of violence and evil. However, here, I have learned self-control, sobriety, kindness, and truth. Whomever we surround ourselves with, whomever we respect and honor, whomever we praise and worship, whether they be virtuous or vicious, we are influenced by them. Just like a fly infects the food it touches, the company we keep will affect us. The wise look for good company, for they fear the stain of bad company. If you wrap rotten fish in grass, eventually the grass will stink just as much. Heaven awaits the righteous. The bad are doomed to hell below." The king was pleased with this teaching by Bupaka. King Panjara also greeted the hermit. The hermit invited King Panjara and his advisor to stay a while and rest at the hermitage. The king and his advisor stayed for a while and learned about cause and effect, courtesy, humility, and the laws of karma. Afterwards, King Panjara returned home and ruled his people righteously based on what he learned from Bupaka and the hermit. After the king's death, he and his people went on to fill the host of heaven. At the end of the Jataka, the Buddha said, "It was not only in this life that Tevatara kept bad company. In that past life, Tevatara was born as Sattigumba and kept company with bandits and criminals. The bandits and criminals of that life are his followers in this life. In that birth, Ananda was born as King Panjara. And I, myself, was born as the parrot Bupaka."
What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.